So, I'm not going to be one of the best speakers, because all those other speakers that were before me, amazing. You're going to get a guy that likes thinking in a more scientific way. This is going to be a lecture almost. And you're going to love it, because we all love lectures.
Yeah.
So, to start all off, we're going to talk about subcultures. And subcultures, and realizing that you hate them, and you will love it, and you'll hate it, and you like things, I like things, and by the end of it, I'm a terrible person. So like that. All right. Closure's not working. All right. So, the basics of communication theory, as learned in COM 1331, if anyone cares. So you have what's missing is actually a person that says communicator, and he's saying something, or he or she is saying something to the receiver, and that message has a ton of noise, and it's not going to be the same message at all. And then the receiver, it kind of has this interpretation, which is represented by the cloud. And that from that interpretation, they give the communicator a kind of like a feedback. So it's kind of like this continuous cycle of no one really understanding anything, but like you're just trying to say your opinion, and it's just not good. It's just not good at all. But we're trying, and that's the best you can ever get. So subcultures are developed because you're trying to express yourself in some meaningful way, and you think it's meaningful, and everyone thinks their stuff matters, and it does. I'm not saying it doesn't. It does, it totally does. Whether you're expressing yourself through mathematics, art, just generally being weird, you're trying to express yourself. But this noise, it comes in so many forms that you feel the need to dress up odd, and no one's gonna understand that. And it's because of this noise and the barriers of communication. You have all these physical things, such as I live in Texas, and some guy in Rhode Island is not going to know anything about Frenchies, and he's not going to know what HEB is, and it's freaking me out. Hell, in Tennessee, they don't have Dreyer's ice cream, they have Ben's ice cream. What is with that? Dreyer's, it's the same thing. You even see the Dreyer's label on it. It's just where it's Ben on it. It's just a ripoff. And then there's barriers due to this medium. I do radio typically. And, well, it's kind of weird because I'm not doing hand gestures right in front of you, but in the radio station, trust me, hand gestures are going everywhere. Hand gestures are just like everywhere. Just like so good. Anyways, and then there are semantic barriers. Like that so pitted thing, you don't know what that is. I know what that is. And you don't. It's okay. You just don't. So pitted. And then there are cultural barriers. Personally, I am of Indian descent, and so I talk about like Indian stuff all the time because like you're Indian, you do Indian things, and stuff like that. Yes, of course you know. And then we have attitudinal behaviors. And that ranges from if right now I'm really, really nervous and it's coming out like this. But typically, you won't get such a talkative person out of me. I went on a date and she was like, oh no, you're not talking too much. I'm like, because I love you. And she was like, that's fucking weird. I was like, it was very odd and in general, a terrible date. If I had a Yelp page, I'm pretty sure she gave me like 2 stars. And then there are barriers due to kind of what we perceive as reality. To me, that date, it was perfect. It was a great concert. My shoes were dirty. We went on a walk for like 30 minutes. This like homeless guy that I'm really good friends with, like, he was like, yo dog, yeah, let me get hold $2 for that mad dog. I was like, homie, like, don't do that. And he was like, alright, I'll get my shit done together. I was like, you do that, Jet. And then he ran away. Stuff happens. And while I thought that day was good, she told me I was weird. And I am. So, we're now going to talk about this. If you can play the video on the right hand side, please. So, what is e-casting, you might ask? E-casting is this Korean thing that like everyone is like totally in the know about. It's about skinny girls eating. I mean, it's just not skinny girls, but it's like your dream girl. Oh, the other video, please. Yeah, the other one, please. So it's about beautiful girls eating food and paying $5 like half an hour to watch them. It's weird, but I have a homie that like lives in Korea now, and he makes like hella money off of this. Like, it's weird. It's a whole studio setup. Okay, if you can play it. And if we see the other video, just back to back. This is short.
What?
It's like not, it's weird to her as well, and she's kind of an activist in that. But you understand that because you just watch a random ass video for 2 minutes. Yeah. If you'll play the next video, this is my homie Zeb Magus. Anyways, yeah. He ran away from home when he was like 12, and then he moved to New York, and then he was just crazy. If you play it.
I saw the video right now.
You should really stop the beat. Okay. pretty much the whole thing is, you're just not going to get it. And it's hard to deal with that. But it's just part of the human experience that we don't communicate telepathically. And let's just deal with that. You're weird, I'm weird, we're all weird. Let's just enjoy each other. Alright, that's really about it.